Sydney is grieving at Westfield Bondi.
In a place that we work in and socialise in and we live in is not right.
At church services.
I was devastated. That horror of those people.
You can see it, you can feel it. These are the victims of the Bondi Junction massacre. Dawn Singleton, daughter of media mogul John. Architect and mother of two, Jade Young. Westfield security guard, Faraz Tahir. 38-year-old new mother, Ash Good. One day, if her baby girl survives herself, she'll be told what mum did for her on April 13, 2024. A day the worst of humanity inspired the best of us.
The events of yesterday have shocked the nation.
Ash's baby was stabbed in her pram and mum chose to thrust her to strangers to protect her rather than protect herself from a maniac.
That is Ash through and through. She did what any mother would have done to protect her child. She was one very, very special lady.
Joel Couchy's knife would kill Ash, five others and wound many more.
We are continuing investigations in relation to him. He's a man, as I said, from Queensland. We believe he came to New South Wales last month. We are and have spoken with his family. We'll continue to do so, and they are cooperating with us.
Couchy has a history of schizophrenia. Wearing an Australian Kangaroos rugby league jersey, he embarked on a stabbing frenzy that has sickened Australia.
Sydney has suffered a horrifying and violent attack on innocent people who were doing something everybody does on the weekend, and that is going shopping.
And we heard everyone screaming, a gun, gun, gun. And it was like an apocalyptic film, like everyone just running like a rampage.
These pictures show what he means. The reaction as shoppers were first hearing what was happening before seeing for themselves. A man running with a pram, the killer himself accosting someone. Shoppers fleeing, different directions, all with the same urgency. Detective Inspector Amy Scott was running too, toward the danger. And as the killer targeted women far more than men, ultimately it was a woman who killed him.
I was behind the police officer when she discharged a firearm, and I have to admit she was amazing. She gave him clear instructions. He went lunged straight at her, and she shot him. She went straight from shooting this guy to giving CPR, and then what she did is she went straight to policing. She moved people away.
That image that we see of her bending over to try and resuscitate a man that she's probably just killed is a compelling hero image.
She's with her family today, which is important, but this state owes her an enormous debt of gratitude.
Amy Scott was not the only hero yesterday. Some armed themselves with chairs, others threw them, and French national Damien Guéraud held off Couchy with a bollard as he advanced up an escalator.
I see the situation. I don't see the guy. I don't see who he was. I just see someone crazy doing crazy stuff, that's it.
We are not looking for anyone else, and we have no other concerns, and people should not be concerned that there is any ongoing threat.
Couchy had arrived at Westfield Bondi Junction a couple of hours before the massacre, carrying the backpack from which he would draw the knife. He ate lunch there.
He just looked like confused, you know, just like, when taking order, it's taking like a long and just, order chicken and curry, just like that.
Shoppers and shop owners were back at Westfield today.
I locked the door. A couple of people came in wanting to feel safe, which I let them in, closed the door and just watched everything unravel.
As floral tributes continue to mount, there are those who know they are fortunate to have escaped.
The panic was huge, like people were screaming and babies were crying and mums were hysterical as well.
Those at one of four Sydney hospitals fortunate to have escaped death but not injury, that includes Yvonne Weinberg, who was released today.
Definitely counting our blessings that she's still here and alive and breathing and still with us.
And there are others haunted by these images as they tried to save the injured and dying. Bondi lifeguard Andrew Reid is among them.
Then we did a little bit more CPR, but she was in a really bad way. I just went around the corner of the escalators and what I saw was just horrific. Like, it was just multiple victims spread out over like 50 metre distances. It's just devastating to think that someone could do something like that to anybody, let alone a baby.
In the immediate aftermath of this atrocity, the possibility of terrorism for police was compelling, not only because of the random nature of the attacks, but also specifically because of where it was, a Jewish enclave against the backdrop of conflicts in the Middle East. It wasn't terrorism, though, and at least one of the victims is Muslim. Faraz Tahir fled Pakistan as a refugee, dying as he protected citizens in his adopted country. Dawn Singleton was raised not far from where she died.
The most perfect human being that I've ever met. Like, she's so sweet, so humble, so down to earth.
Of 11 patients transported to hospital, 10 were women. Most of the dead were women. So was that an ideology, or were they just softer targets?
I can say that the man has never been arrested by police in Queensland, nor has he been charged with any criminal offence.
Couchy was diagnosed with schizophrenia aged 17. He was raised in Toowoomba.
He sort of kept to himself. He was quiet and he didn't mix a lot with other children, I don't think.
His family is in shock.
They have sent a message to the New South Wales Police Force with respect to support of the police officer who has killed their son and expressing their concerns for her welfare.
Couchy came to Sydney earlier this year, no fixed address, and his belongings were kept at a storage facility. A male escort with no criminal history who gains infamy now as one of Australia's worst mass murderers.
People going about their Saturday afternoon shopping should be safe, shouldn't be at risk. And for people who were forced to be locked in shops, people who ran from danger, people who confronted that danger, ordinary Australians putting themselves in harm's way in order to help their fellow citizens, that bravery was quite extraordinary.